In this session, we are looking about the project execution. So, what is the project execution? Have to go with it. We'll look into this. So, now coming into the topic, now here what we are doing is whether you have done with your internship or you're going with the internship, that doesn't like matters here. So, this session is like for some people who have completed the course, who are going with the course and like who have recently joined. So for all of them, it is a session. Have to install the software, have to get your project, have to import it, have to run it. So in this session, we'll be looking into them. So for you people, you'd be getting a link for your software in your Telegram group. So here is a software link. So when you have gone through this particular folder, you would be getting your complete softwares. So here in this you have Python 32, Python 34. Two types of softwares are there, like based upon your architecture, whether your system is 32 bit or 64 bit architecture. So I'll show you how to find your architecture. You'd be having this PC or my computer. So please, you need to go to that. Right click on this PC, properties. So here you can find your system architecture and your system details. So in this system details, what we are going to consider is, so here chose 64 bit operating system. So that means you people need to download 64 bit operating system files. So let us go back to the software link. In this you can find Python 64 and Python 32. So 32 is for the people who are using 32-bit operating system, and 64 is for the people who are using 64-bit operating system. So click on this. You'd be having an option called as download. So please download this tool. So I've already downloaded it. Based upon your internet speed, it takes a little bit of time. It is around 300 MB file. So as soon as you download it, you'd be getting in this particular way. So this is what the file. So in order to open this file, you need to have WinRAR software in your system. So go to Google, type WinRAR download. So when you go with this, WinRAR tool will be downloaded. Click on download. The tool will be download. After downloading, please click on install. So this software would be installed. So click like this. You'll be getting this pop-up. Yes. And click on next, next, next. The WinRAR would be installed in your system. As of now, it is installed in my system, so I'm not going with it. So you can find your file. After installing the WinRAR, you need to select the file, right click the software which you have downloaded. So extract to Python 64. So when you do this, your software would be what do you see? It has been extracted to a folder called as Python 64. So it will be found in the desktop. As of now, my folder is in the desktop, so I can find Python 64 on my desktop. So if you have downloaded, it would be in your downloads folder or like where your download location. So let us wait until it has been extracted. And if you are having any other softwares or any other versions of Python and so on, so you can uninstall them. First of all, you need to uninstall it. So here I've extracted my tool. So in this, you can find three folders. Yes. So coming back to the topic here, you are having PyCharm, Python, and VAM server. These three tools you require for running your project, whether it is a Django project or ML project or data science or AI. So I'll explain you the structure also. So before going that, we require these tools. So if you have any other Python version, please uninstall it. So how do you uninstall the other version, sir? Click on Control Panel. So as soon as your Control Panel has been opened, now go to Programs and Features. When you click on this, you'd be getting a list of installed tools in your system. So as of now, check what the Python version is there. So I'm uninstalling my Python, which is the version is there in my system. Based upon your system speed, it would be uninstalled. You people don't need to install 3.6. If you are having any 3.4, 3.9, and so on other versions, then it would be collided. Like what would be happened is system will not understand to which version of the Python it should use to run your project. So this would be happen. So that is the reason what do we say is install only a specific version, that is 3.6. And for the people who are using Windows 7, 3.6 is not supported. So then in this case you need to go with the below versions like 3.4, like 3.2 and so on. Don't go with again below version of 3. Yes. For what? Yeah, for what? That's fine, so please go with the session, I'll speak at the last. You good name? Right, so Python 3.6 has been uninstalled. You need to uninstall the Python launcher also. It takes a little bit of time based upon your system speed. I'll share you this link in the Telegram group, Google Classroom, or like your respective mail IDs which you have registered, so you can download the files. Right, so completely it has been installed. So let's start from the first installation. So meanwhile, you can check with your Telegram group. A link has been posted for you. So where you can download all the software, this Google Drive link. Expecting in your group you'd be getting a link, so Surface link. Go to that particular link and download the Surface. Right, so let's start with the installation. First, after extracting your Surface file, so now go to the folder, first install Python. So click on install. So before clicking on install, you need to do add Python 3.6 to the path. Select these two options, click on install now. Then your Python would be installed based upon your system speed. After installing the Python, then you need to install the PyCharm. So PyCharm is a tool for importing your code, editing your code and so on. So this tool you require. So here also you have specific version for that. So if you're using the latest, it is not a problem. But for the Python, you need to use a specific version itself. If you're having multiple versions, you'd be getting the clashes. Like Windows can't understand whether to use which version for your project. So in that case, it will cause you a problem to execute your project. So this is an IDE. PyCharm is an IDE. Python is a tool for your programming. So coming to the WAMP server. So in this WAMP, you would be having MySQL. MySQL is a database server which we are using for our project. Right, so we need to install the WAMP server also. So before installing WAMP server, you need to check your system is updated properly and there are no clashes. So if like when your system is updating and you have shredded suddenly, you don't have internet, like you have dropped it middly. So in that cases, your system will not be updated properly and you even don't know that. So then in that case, while installing this WAMP server, you'd be getting the errors. So those error numbers are msvcr110.dll missing, 120.dll missing, 140.dll missing. So this is what the first error which is caused while installing your Surface. So that is done because if your system is not updated properly, if you're not having the .NET frameworks from 2012 to the up to the latest one, if any one of the .NET framework is missing in your system, then you would be getting this error. So if you don't want to get such kind of errors, so then come back to the Surface folder. Here you would be having the files, WAMP error tool files. So based upon the error which you are getting, you need to download the files over here. So it would be 12, 18, like some random versions would be there. You can download all the files and check which version is missing in your system and you can install it. If you don't want to go in this way, go to the Google and type type that particular file name and the version 2012, 2015, 17, 18, 9, 10. So what is the error you are getting? Check with it and download that particular version. Right, so if you download, you'd be getting the same files. So in this, you're not having the file number. You can download this and you can install it. No need to install everyone. Those who are getting the errors, only those people need to install this. Right, so that's fine. So Python has been installed. So click close. After installing the Python, now we need to go with the PyCharm. So let's install the Python PyCharm. This is what the location of your PyCharm, where it has been installed. Now you need to click on next. So your system operating like bit 32 bit or 64 bit, select it, click on next. So when you do this, your PyCharm would be installed in your system. Yeah, so PyCharm has been installed. So we are done with the two tools. So coming to next one, you need to go with WAMP server. So click on this, it would be installed. Click on next and install it. So WAMP server would be installed. Only you'd be getting the problems in this particular tool. So with the Python, with the PyCharm, you won't get any issues. So if you're following the same files, even though if you're following the same version for the WAMP, you may get the errors. So why? Because if your system is already having a MySQL server or a XAMPP server, so this WAMP or XAMPP can be used. So if you have any MySQL server, even that also can be used. If you don't want to use that, you need to stop that service. If you are having MySQL server in your system, right? So then in this case, press Windows R, services.msc. So type this command, services would be open. So here you need to stop the MySQL. So here nothing to do in the WAMP, click on open again, you'd be getting next. Finish. So by this you'd be done with your WAMP server installation, right? So after successfully done with your WAMP server, so what would be happened is, in the below here in the taskbar you can find an icon called as W. So if this icon is in green color, that means your software WAMP server has been installed successfully. If you're getting orange or red, you'd be having the problems. So as discussed, msvcr110.dll missing. For that you need to add the .NET framework files. So in the second case, if you are having any antivirus, that antivirus would be blocking your ports. So you need to give the exclusion in your antivirus for the WAMP server or the XAMPP server. That is the second issue. Coming to the third issue, if the port is being used by any other tool, basically when you're going with a tool, port 8080 or 8080 would be used by four different software. First one is TeamViewer, Skype, TeamViewer, Skype, antivirus. If you are having your any antivirus, that antivirus also will acquire the port number 80 or 8080. So if you are using any of these tools, if you have installed before the VAM server, there is a chance like this ports would be acquired by any one of this tool. So then in this case, if you are trying to turn on your VAM server, you would be getting an orange color icon. So it says two services are running out of three. So let me put it into online first of all. Click on put online over here. So as soon as it has been turned on, it'd be getting it into green color. Right. So you can see a server is online. So when I click here, all the three services would be started. Right. So if you are having orange color, when you take the cursor onto that particular icon, it says 2 out of 3. So it means in that case, your Apache server is not running. Right. So if you have any port problem, if you like this has already said you like if you are having any other things and you are getting an error called as httpd.config, such kind of error. So then in this case, come to your VAM server, click stop all services. After stopping all the services, now come back to your this icon, click on this, go to Apache. Again here you can find httpd.config file. Open this file. So now press Ctrl F, type 80. So you can find the port number called as 80 over here. If anyone is getting an error of this port httpconfig.error or server could not be started, so then in this case, those people please change your port number here. Put it to 1234 here, and the below also put it to 1234. And save the document, right? So this is what you need to do, right? So as of now, my port is running successfully. No need to change, right? So save it. So now, if you want to check whether your database has been installed or not properly, so click on VAM server, put restart all services. If you have done with changes in the HTTP config file, so put restart all services. So then you'd be getting this into the green color. After getting that into green color, click on localhost. So when you click on localhost, you'd be getting a dashboard. So this is what the dashboard. So in this, click on php my admin. So note down this point. So when you click on this php my admin, defaultly you'd be having the username. Defaultly you'd be having a username of root and password is empty. No need to type any password. Right, so I've click here, user is root and password is empty. Please don't even type empty, leave it blank. Click on glow. So what would be happen? Your database dashboard would be displayed. So this is what your database, right? So we have installed tools successfully.